Good morning, students. Today we are dealing with the topic plant growth and development. Page number 276. We know that some trees like banyan trees, they continue to grow for thousands of years, whereas some annual plants, they stop their growth within a season or within a year. So simply, growth. What is growth? Growth is a measurable, irreversible, permanent increase in size, shape, volume and number, also in dry weight. So growth is, we can measure growth and it is permanent. We can't be reverse the growth. It is irreversible and increase in volume, size, shape, number and dry weight. In plants, the growth occurs by cell division, cell differentiation, cell enlargement and last, cell maturation. So, cell, the growth occurs by cell division, cell differentiation, cell enlargement and maturation. So, one single maize root apical meristem may grow 17,500 new cells per hour. So, maize apical root meristem may produce new cells, that is 17,500 new cells per hour. So, we can imagine how much they grow per hour. Like that, watermelon may produce 3,50,000 new cells per hour and they are increasing their size. So, we can calculate how much they are growing per hour. We know that bamboos are evergreen grasses and they can grow 91 centimeter per day. So, 91 centimeter can grow per day. So, that means by one day they can reach up to 91 centimeter. So, just imagine how they are growing per day. And if we look the same, some cactus species, it takes more than 1 year to grow 1 inch. So, a cactus species called Sakura, it takes more than 10 years for the growth of 1 inch. And it does not flower for more than many years. It takes almost 75 to 100 years for growing a single sidearm. So, these are about the growth. So, growth is an irreversible, permanent, measurable increase in size, shape, volume and number, also in its dry weight. Growth occurs by cell division, differentiation, enlargement and maturation. Here are some examples that related to growth. Now we can move to the characteristics of growth. What are the characteristics of growth? Growth increases in protoplasm at cellular level. So, the protoplasm of the cell protoplasm increases. Cell protoplasm increases at cellular level. Then, there are two types of growth, open form growth and closed form growth. Open form growth and growth is limitless growth. It can grow. It is indeterminate growth. Open form growth is indeterminate growth. The stem and root are indeterminate growth. It can can continuously grow due to the rapid and continuous cell division. So the next one is closed form growth. Closed form growth is determined growth. Closed form growth is determined growth. That is flower, leaves, fruits, they are limited. Their growth is limited and it is called closed form growth or determined growth. There are some plants like monocarpic annual plants produce flowers only once during the lifetime and it may die. So their growth is only for 1 year. Monocarpic annuals. Monocarpic annuals are they flower once in a year. After the flowering, they may die. Examples are paddy and bean. Whereas monocarpic perennials. Monocarpic perennials, they also flower once in a year, but they don't die after the flowering. They may survive for many years. Example, bamboo. Last one is polycarpic perennials. Polycarpic perennials are plants that produce flowers every year during their lifetime. They can produce flower in their every seasons or every year. So monocarpic annuals are plants that can flower only once in their life cycle. After flowering, they may die. Whereas monocarpic perennials, they can flower in every season or every year, but after the flowering, they may not die. Then polycarpic perennials are plants they can produce every year during their lifetime. Example are coconut. So these are the characteristics of growth. So you are looking characteristics, you just go through that. While growth takes place, the protoplasm of the cell increases, and two types of growth, open form growth and closed form growth. In open form growth, it is indeterminate growth, whereas closed form growth, it is determinate growth. And we know that the primary growth may take place due to the activity of rapid cell division in root as well as shoot apical meristem, whereas the secondary growth is happen due to the vascular cambium activity. These vascular cambium activity and secondary growth we can discuss later in another chapter. Now we can go to the kinetics of growth. Kinetics of growth. Kinetics of growth is simply the analysis of cell motion. Analysis of cell motion or expansion. Cell motion or expansion. So, in kinetics of growth, there are two. One, stages of growth. Second one, types of growth. First one, stages of growth. Second one, types of growth. Let me detail look in the stages of growth. Stages of growth. There are four main stages. One, lag phase. Two, log phase. 3. Maturation phase. 4. Decline phase. So there are 4 stages of growth: lag phase, log phase, maturation phase, and declining phase. We can discuss this lag phase, log phase, and maturation by using a graph. So, the total period from the initial growth to the final growth stage. The period from the starting stage to the ending stage of growth is called, this is the initial point and this is the final point of growth. This time period is called the grand period of growth. So, the total period, grand period growth. So, the total period from the initial to final stage of growth is called grand period of growth. If we plot the growth against time, y-axis is time and x-axis is growth. If we plot growth against this time, we get a S-shaped sigmoid curve. We get a S-shaped sigmoid curve. From this graph, we can discuss the stages of growth. This is the lag stage. This is the log stage, and this is the maturation stage. And finally, decline stage. These are the four phases or stages. First one, lag stage. Lag stage is the initial phase of the growth. Initial phase of growth is called lag stage. Actually, the growth starts from this stage. In this phase, the new cells are formed from pre-existing cells. The new cells are formed from the pre-existing cells, but the growth is slow. So, lag phase is the initial phase and where the growth starts. In this stage, new cells are formed from the pre-existing cells in slow manner. Second one is log phase. Log phase also called as exponential growth. This is the second stage of the growth. Log phase. In this log phase, the cells actively involved in dividing. The cells, pre-existing cells, no cells are formed in active manner. That is, rapid cell division occurs in the log phase. Also, in log phase, the new cell increase in size. The new cells, the newly formed cells from the log phase, they increase in size by the deposition of some cell wall materials. So, and the growth is very fast in this log phase. So, lag phase, then it's log phase. Log phase is nothing but it is exponential growth, whereas the cell division is very much faster than the log phase. Here, the newly divided cell increases its size by the deposition of some cell wall materials. Now, maturation phase. In maturation phase, the cell wall thickening maybe increases. In this phase, it is a steady phase. You can see it is a steady phase. In this phase, there is no further cell division occurs. There is no further cell division occurs and the cell undergo differentiation. The cell undergo differentiation and further the cell wall thickening may increases due to the particle deposition on the inner surface of the cell wall. Due to the particle deposition in the inner surface of the cell wall, the cell may become more and more thick and further cell division may not take place in this maturation stage. So in this maturation stage, the growth ceases. There is no further growth. That's why we got a steady line here. The growth ceases or the growth stop, and this differentiation and maturation takes place due to the deposition in the inner surface of the cell wall. Finally, decline stage. The word itself, we can understand that what is decline stage. Decline stage. In this stage, there is no cell division, no further cell thickening or anything. The cell undergo low metabolic process. So due to this low metabolic process, the cell may become die or it may undergo the senescence stage. So these are the four phases of growth: lag phase, log phase, maturation phase, and declining phase. Of the stages in growth, right? Four stages: lag phase, log phase, declination phase, and maturation phase. now types of growth rate. We know that what is a growth rate? The increased growth per unit time is growth rate. Increased growth per unit time is growth rate. Simply growth per time. The increased growth per unit time is called growth rate. There are two types of growth rate: arithmetic growth rate and geometric growth rate. So let me discuss what is arithmetic growth rate. Arithmetic growth rate is the length of a plant organ is plotted against the time. It shows a linear curve. If we plot length of a plant organ against time, we get a linear curve. It is called arithmetic growth. So this represents that the growth rate is constant and the growth rate increases in an arithmetic manner. In arithmetic growth, only one cell is allowed to divide between the two resting progeny cells. So in arithmetic growth, only one cell is allowed to divide it. The rest of the cells become the body cells. So if we consider this is a cell and it divided to produce two cells, and again this cell undergo division. These cells as such become the body cells. So this become the body cell. These two after become the body cells. And these cells again undergo division and produce one dividing cell and the rest three body cells. So the division will goes in an arithmetic manner. So after each round of cell division, only one single cell is capable of division and the rest of the cells become the body cells. These are called the arithmetic growth manner. The plant single dividing cell undergo a millions round of cell division. We know that a single cell in a plant, a single cell undergo a million rounds of cell division. But if we look, this type of manner is happened, then the growth take millions of years to complete an organ. If this type of growthing is takes place in a leaf, so that leaf complete its growth, that leaf require millions of years to complete that growth. So this may happen in small plant organs like plant hair, bristles, plant organs. This arithmetic growth type pattern is happening. The rest all the growth is geometric growth rate. So we plotted one graph now, time and the growth of that plant organ. So if we look, so the arithmetic growth rate is Lt equal to L0 plus Rt, whereas Lt is the length at time t, L0 is the length at time 0, and R is the growth rate of elongation per unit, whereas t is the time. So this is a formula for calculating the arithmetic growth rate. Now we are discussing about the geometric growth. Okay, then the second type of growth rate is geometric growth rate. This type of growth rate takes place in higher plant organs and higher plants. So we look
In the arithmetic growth rate, we consider length, whereas in geometric growth rate, we measure the weight or size. In this type of growth rate, during the cell division, all the cells are mitotically active. We already discussed about the arithmetic growth rate. In the arithmetic growth rate, only one cell is capable of division, whereas in this geometric growth rate, all the cells are capable of dividing, keep on dividing, that is mitotically active. And this type of growth is occur in large plant parts or large plants. If we consider this is a cell, it's a mother cell, and after division, it gives two cells. So, instead of arithmetic growth rate, in this geometric growth rate, these two new progeny cells are capable of dividing. So, it may produce four progeny cells. Again, these cells undergo division, it may produce eight progeny cells. So, this is called the mitotically active dividing cells. So, if we look the geometric growth rate, WT, W1 equal to WoE raised to RT, whereas W1 is the final size or final weight, final height or final number of the organ, whereas WO is the initial size, that is the beginning size, R is the growth rate, and T is the time, where E is the base of natural organisms. So these are about the arithmetic growth rate and geometric growth rate. And for so many plants, both these arithmetic and geometric growth are takes place. At the embryonic level, the geometric growth is takes place, whereas it attain a certain organ stage, it undergo arithmetic growth. Now, we can compare the absolute growth and relative growth. We plug or we draw two leaves at a particular time, and we measure the growth, and after a given period of time, again we pluck the same leaf from the plants, and we measure that growth also. So, if we consider the initial growth of this small leaf is 5 cm and the initial growth of this big leaf is 50 cm. So, after a particular time, we pluck another leaf and we measure it. If these leaves become 10 cm square and these leaves become 55 cm square, we can name the first drawn leaf as A and the second drawn leaf as B, and the first drawn small leaves as A, the first drawn big leaf as B, and the second drawn small leaves as A raised to 1, and the second drawn big leaves is B raised to 1. If we calculate the growth, A raised to 1 minus A and B raised to 1 minus B for 10 minus Y equal to 5, whereas 55 minus 50 equal to 5. So the absolute growth is similar or same in both the leaf, as small leaf as well as big leaves. The absolute growth is same for both the leaves. But if we consider the relative growth, the relative growth is high for this leaf compared to this leaf. Why? Because we can easily look at the growth difference. In this big leaf, the growth difference is relatively small. Why? Because the size of the leaf is as such. Whereas in the compared to these small leaves, the size of the leaves become large compared to the size of the big leaves. So the relative growth is high for the small leaves, and absolute growth is equal for both the leaves. In your textbook, page number 279, there is an experiment called arc oximeter. You just go through the experiment, and if you feel any doubt, you may feel free to ask it. I just simply explain what it is. We tie a rope in the growing part of the plant, and in the other end of the rope we are placing a weight. This is a pulley, and this is the apparatus. Here there are so many measurements are there. When the plant undergrow growth, that is the plant become grow, these strings may move, and this string may move through the pulley, and this weight may comes down. So this pointer may move from somewhere here to somewhere here. So we can measure this distance between the movement of the pointer. So by using this distance, we can calculate how much growth is takes place in this plant. There is an equation for calculating the how much the growth takes place. Actually, the actual growth in length, the length of the growth takes place equal to the distance traveled by the pointer. The distance traveled by the pointer and the radius of the pulley. This is the pulley and the radius of the pulley divided by length of the pointer. This is the length of the pointer. So we can calculate the actual length of the growth by the distance traveled by the pointer into the radius of the pulley divided by the length of the pointer. So these are about the arc oximeters. So next we can move to the plant growth regulator section.